Example number 2. The resistance between points A and B in the circuit shown in the figure is. Options are 10 ohm, 20 ohm, 30 ohm, 40 ohm. So all resistances are 10 ohm. Between points A and B, you have to find the equivalent resistance. Now, this is point A, this is point B. So, when you travel from A to B, you will go along this 10 ohm resistance. Then, there is a split in the path. Either you can go this way or you can go this way. Your destiny is to reach point B. So, you will go through this resistor and reach B along this path. So, during this resistance and this resistance are not traced. So, these two resistances can be removed. They do not offer any resistance when you are going from A to B. So you can rewrite this circuit as, so starting from A, I'll get first this 10 ohm, then there is split at this point. So split, there are two paths. So one is this 10 ohm, then after this one more 10 ohm is there along the same path, then along other path, one 10 ohm, that is this resistance, another 10 ohm, that is this resistance. So, these are traced. Then, after this, the paths merge here. So, they have merged. There is one more 10 ohm resistance, that is this. Then you reach point B. Now it is, this is the modified circuit. So these two resistances will be ineffective because no current flows through them. Now simplify the resistances. This 10 and 10 are in series. Effective will be 20. So this 10 and 10 are in series. Effective is 20. Now 20, 20 are in parallel, effective will be 10. So entire parallel combination gives you 10 ohm. Now 10 ohm, 10 ohm and this 10 ohm, all are in series. So effective resistance will be 30 ohm. So 30 ohm, that is option C.